When developing a Node.js project, you need to restart your application in order to see code changes take effect. Instead of starting and stopping the process manually, we can have our application restart automatically on file changes. To do this, we can create an Npm script and use a tool called Nodemon. In this tutorial, we're going to create two Npm scripts, a start script and a dev script. We'll discuss how dev dependencies are handled from Npm scripts, and we'll explain why you might want to ignore certain files while using Nodemon. Like I mentioned, after making changes to a file in a Node.js project, you need to restart the application in order to see the changes take effect. This typically looks like stopping the process and starting it over again. Doing this manually every time you make a change gets old real fast, and it's easy to forget to do. That's where a tool like Nodemon comes in handy. Nodemon is a CLI tool available on Npm that will run your Node.js application and restart the process whenever a JavaScript file is saved. This saves us from having to stop and start the project manually. Specifically, Nodemon watches for changes to JavaScript and JSON files. Keep that in mind because it will become important later. In this tutorial, we're going to create two Npm scripts. First, we will create a simple start script. This will be responsible for starting the application and will consist of just the commands needed to do so. Second, we will create a dev script. This will be used during development of the project to restart the application on file changes. The dev script will use Nodemon to run the start script. So here we have a simple project. It uses a package called cowsay to print a cow-themed message to the console. To run it normally, we'd type node index.js into the terminal. The first thing we want to do is create a start script for this project. So we open the package.json file, go to the scripts field, and add a start script. After we've added the start script, we can run npm start in the terminal to start the project. All the start script is doing is running the index.js file for us. Creating a start script is good practice because it ensures that any changes to how the application is run only need to happen in one place. Our next step is to install Nodemon. You could install Nodemon globally, and if you already have it installed, that's fine, but we are going to add it to this project as a dev dependency. This makes sure that anyone who runs the application can run our dev script without having to first install Nodemon globally. It also ensures that everyone is going to be using the same version of Nodemon to run the application during development. That's not a huge deal with Nodemon specifically, but for any other tools you use during development, making sure everyone uses the same version can prevent a lot of headaches people might encounter by having a different version of the tool than you do. So let's install Nodemon as a dev dependency. Now that Nodemon has been installed to the project, we can create our dev script. Back in package.json, we'll create a new script entry called dev. The name of the script doesn't matter, by the way. You could choose whichever name you wanted, but I like to choose dev since we're going to be using this script specifically for running the project during development. We could make our dev script just run Nodemon without any arguments. This works fine, as Nodemon will by default run the index.js file that it finds in the project directory. But we want to make sure that Nodemon executes our start script. To do that, we pass the --exec flag and the command we want Nodemon to execute. In this case, we're telling Nodemon to run the start script whenever it detects changes to files in the project. Note that I wrapped the command it'll execute in single quotes. One of the big benefits of using npm scripts is that we don't have to pass the full path to dependencies we want to run from the command line. Outside of an npm script, in order to run a dependency from the command line, we'd have to pass the full path to the executable in our node modules folder. So for Nodemon, it would look something like this. But with npm scripts, you just need to use the name of the package, and npm will find the package executable in your node modules folder for you. Let's save our package.json, and now we're ready to use the dev script. To use the dev script to start the project, we'll execute npm run dev in the terminal. You can see Nodemon outputs some information to the terminal, and the project was run. Now let's make an edit in our index.js file and see what happens. I'll make a change in the code, save the file, and you'll see in the terminal window our project restarted with the updated message. That's basically it. Run the dev script, make changes, save the file, and see your project restart. Now your days of manually restarting your project during development are over. The next step is going to be optional, but will come in handy if your application makes changes to files while running, like writing to a JSON file, for example. Nodemon will restart the project when it detects changes to JavaScript or JSON files. If your application writes to a JavaScript or JSON file, maybe for updating config details or storing some kind of data, Nodemon will prematurely restart the application once those files are written to. Luckily, Nodemon lets you specify files and directories to ignore. We can edit our dev script in the package.json and tell Nodemon to ignore some files. To do so, we pass the --ignore flag to Nodemon, along with a file, directory, or pattern to ignore. Let's assume we have JSON files stored in a directory called data. We can tell Nodemon to ignore changes to all the JSON files in the data directory. We're using a wildcard here to ignore just the JSON files that might be in the data directory. Now Nodemon won't restart based on changes to those files. This is important whenever you want to use Nodemon with an application that edits files, otherwise Nodemon will restart your project constantly at the wrong times. In this tutorial, we created a start script and a dev script. The start script specifies how to run the application, and the dev script uses Nodemon to restart the project on changes during development. We described how dev dependencies are handled from Npm scripts, and why you would want to install Nodemon as a dev dependency instead of globally. And we explained how to ignore files with Nodemon to prevent premature restarts of your application.